My name is Rodney Barber, and I'm excited to be talking to you today from the Verdun Organ Division in Cincinnati, Ohio. We're coming to the end of our series here of 10 pistons, and we're going to do three today, 8, 9, and 10. And these are all pistons that you will be able to use to play hymns and also as a basis to start looking at all kinds of classic organ literature. So let's get started. Piston number 8. We're going to create what we call a principal chorus. Another term that's very similar might be foundation chorus. You might see that in some of your organ literature, but it's the same essential thing. And I'm going to create that today by using principles 8 and 4 on the great. I'm going to put on my swell to great and choir to great couplers, and I'm going to add the principles from the swell. Let's listen to them first. They sound a little thinner, don't they? And then I'm going to go down to my bottom, my choir, and I'm going to use my principles here. So you have thinner ones on each keyboard, but when I combine them together and add principles in the pedal, what I am doing on this digital organ by combining those together is again taking advantage of the speaker locations. The swell could be over here, the choir could be over here, the great is often in the middle, so I'm surrounding my congregation with dimension and with depth, and that creates a supportive sound. So this sound would be good for hymns, especially to introduce them first verse, and hymns with slow harmonic rhythm. So there's my piston number 8, the foundation or the principal chorus. For my piston number 9, I am simply going to add the 2 foots and the mixtures to that. Remember, mixtures are high-pitched sounds. And let's just actually listen to that mixture first. I'm going to play one of those. If you can analyze that, you're actually hearing, this is a 5-rank mixture. You're hearing 5 pitches there. Now, what this is it provides clarity to the top of the ensemble. What it's not designed to do is what I'm irritating you with right now by holding this note. If you play slow harmonic rhythms on this note, people with hearing loss or hearing aids are going to say you are playing the organ too loud. So I'm going to lift that off and release us from that pain. I'm going to add, though, all the mixtures and the 4 foots, the 2 foots, the 8 foots, the 16ths in the pedal, and play a hymn with fast harmonic rhythm. So I can play a little bit louder. I can use the full sounds of the resources of the organ again to give dimension and depth to the sound. And I'm not irritating you with those mixtures because I'm not sustaining notes or playing them. Let's go back and play a slow harmonic movement hymn. Let's just go back to our first piston number 8. I hope you see there's really not a significant difference in the volume there. It's just those high harmonic pitches, which are great when we have quick harmonic movement. But that hymn, to me, sounds better on that registration, okay? So we've got the piston 8 with foundations. We've got piston 9 with 8-4-2 and mixtures, our principal chorus. That's what we'll call that, with mixtures. And our last piston, what I'm going to do is take that principal chorus with mixtures and simply add our chorus reeds to that, creating a principal chorus with a reed ensemble. So on Christmas Day, joy to the world, or O come all ye faithful. On Easter, Christ the Lord is risen today. When you have a majestic hymn like Crown Him with Many Crowns. For your last verse or for your introduction, you can use that reed ensemble to add weight and majesty to the sound of the organ for the festival occasions in your worship. Any hymn can be played with those three pistons, though, to give variety in the verses. You could do your first verse with reed introduction, then play the verse, a second verse, a final verse. And so use those three pistons to create a wonderful ensemble and accompaniment for that hymn. Now, in classic organ literature, we're going to use many of these same sounds. This organ has them divided into different suites. So I'm going to play now in the symphonic suite. What I can do on this instrument is touch another button. This is called Baroque, and I'm going to instantly change all of these samples to German samples. And you may not be able to tell on your computer speakers, but listen and see if you can hear a difference in this. I hope you could hear that was brighter, it was more silvery, and it was closer to the Silbermann and the Schnitger organs that J.S. Bach composed that piece on. In this organ, we have four different types of sounds in different organ families that we can choose from. But the main thing I want everyone to know is I was using those pistons 8, 9, and 10 that we talked about. That was piston number 10 with the reed chorus to play the Bach. All I did was change the samples to German samples. So that begins a whole nother series of videos that we may talk to you about in the future, showing you how to use all of the resources of an organ like this to use pistons that you've already set to create the exact sound that will help the piece that you're playing be communicated to the listener in the best way, in the way the composer intended, and in the way you want to express yourself. So I know you're probably tired, if you've watched all of these, of hearing me say this, but we've gone through string ensembles, we've talked about different octaves of playing those. We've gone through solo voices, and we've looked in our personal control center here to choose flutes, bassoons, oboes, all kinds of different solo instruments. We've explored the traditional organ cornet, and looked at different accompaniments for that, and we've even turned that into a gospel sound by using the tremulant. We've looked at two different, for our piston number four, flute types of sounds. Number one, Baroque flutes, and number two, a choral à ensemble using flute celeste and flute voices to support that. Number five, we had the harpsichord and strings. We played Baroque music, we played Michael W. Smith, we played contemporary songs, we played hymns with that. The brass ensemble for festive occasions, along with the solo trumpet on number seven. And now 8, 9, and 10, we've created registrations for you to play any hymn, and as a basis to begin to play your classical music, your Bach, your Buxtehude, and composers like that that use these full organ ensembles. So, we have given you from Verdun Organ Division a lot to think about. I hope you will sit down with each one of these, review all of these videos. I hope you will take the pieces that you already know and begin to explore them using amazing sounds. And once again, if you want some more amazing sounds that you don't have on your organ, please call us at Verdun Organ Division and we'll be glad to show you the resources of the instruments that we have available. So once again, I'm Rondi Barber. I thank you for watching these. If you have any questions, please call us at the Verdun Organ Division.